Factor common factors and grouping. Factor a GCF. When we factor, what we're doing is that we are kind of undoing, this is, here is factored. Before we would distribute, and we're just undoing this. We would have had AB plus AC. Remember that a factor is something that's multiplied. We're going to put the GCF, the greatest common factor, in front and divide each term by the GCF. And then what left is left over goes into the parentheses. So here is the leftover. Out here is the GCF. So let's take a look at how that works in our first example. Okay, first thing I'm going to look at is my numbers. I have 9, 12, and 6. So it looks like my common factor there is going to be a 3. So I'm dividing each of those by 3. And it looks like they all have x's. And remember that our rule for our variables is that we take the lowest exponent. Our lowest exponent here is 2. So we're dividing each one of those by 3x squared. Now I'm going to put my parentheses. And we're going to write what's left over inside. So I have 9 divided by 3, which would be 3. X fourth divided by x squared is going to be x squared. Remember, we're subtracting the exponents. Minus 12 divided by 3 is 4. X cubed divided by x squared would be x. Plus 6 divided by 3 would be 2. And x squared divided by x squared is just 1, so those don't have to be written down. And there I have factored out my greatest common factor, and this is what we consider to be factored. Now, let's take a look at our second example. Again, I want to take a look at my numbers first. 21, 14, and 7 all have a common factor of 7. And it looks like they all have a's. And my lowest exponent is going to be 2, so we're going to be dividing by 7a squared. And they looks like they all have a b in common also. My lowest exponent for my b is a 4, so we're dividing by b to the 4th also. Okay, set up my parentheses to write my leftovers in. 21 divided by 7 is going to be 3. A to the 4th divided by a squared is a squared. B to the 5th divided by b is going to be b. Always keep in mind we're subtracting the exponents. 14 divided by 7 is going to be 2. A cubed divided by a squared is a. B to the 7th divided by b to the 4th is going to be b cubed. 7 divided by 7 is 1. A squared divided by a squared is 1, of which I already have it written down. And I have b to the 4th divided by b to the 4th, which is 1. I already have that written. So there we go. Whenever you have this happen here, that this whole thing is 1, you have to write the 1. It is a placeholder. If you started with 3 terms, you need to end with 3 terms.